databases that would assist countries to manage the knowledge that they have. And here that was, so not only what's available in terms of minerals, it's also obviously got a strong focus on environment, on all the different layers within the water column, on the biota, and crucially as well, the cultural knowledge of the different island states, so that they're able to, that we're recognising and they're able to utilise that knowledge effectively. So that's it. I invite your input now or throughout the day as we redraft that paper. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Charles. Any comments from the floor? Yeah, Tirunaki.
Oh, thanks for the presentation. This is obviously the best group in the house. But apart from that, the comment I want to make is in regards to, again, I'm coming back to the transboundary, and I think it's more directed at the legal working group. And in the case of transboundary, you know, the fact that the area, I'm talking about the activities in the area, it's said that the area or benefits from the area will be the common heritage of mankind. I'm not saying, in no way am I saying that being close to the area, we're any better off than Hawaii or Mexico. But in the instance, I'm getting to the fact where in any instance of material damage or catastrophe, will it be the common heritage of mankind as well? So it's just a way of Kiribati reaching out to its brothers and sisters in the region, as is this meeting is about, to maybe find a way to address that issue. I know it's, and the government of Kiribati understand that it's very difficult to address it, but just pointing it out would be good, as I'm doing now. Thank you.
Robert, you may wish to respond to that.
Yeah, there's some very good papers on the question of liability in the case that there is environmental damage. And the general position is that a coastal state would be able to claim compensation in the case that there was damage, as would group of states on behalf of the area. One of the issues that needs to be borne in mind, however, is that states per se, if they're satisfying appropriate levels of due diligence, will not be liable.
Okay, any further questions before we break for tea? Okay, thank you very much. Adam, may we?
Okay, so we're going to give you slightly longer for tea. It's now just coming up to 20 past 10. We're going to meet again at 10:45. Now, please use that time to go through these documents. It'll be the last chance to have input and comments on them before the working groups can finalise, or the chairs of the working groups can finalise these documents. So if you have any thoughts, comments, questions, please be prepared to bring them up after tea. If you want to speak to people through tea, that's fine, but we need to finalise these documents. And then we'll have just a bit of a general discussion. So 10:45 sharp, please. Thanks a lot. Okay, welcome back everyone for the final stretch. A couple of housekeeping points first. Delegates who are leaving or checking out of the Sofitel from this afternoon to Sunday morning should double check with Lisa or Vera for drop-off at the airport. And the three documents are available on the back table if you need another copy of them. And I believe it's a tidied up version of the EIA document. So hopefully you've now had a chance to read through these documents, and really it's open for any discussion and comments to the various working groups on your thoughts now you've had a chance to go through these documents. So I open up the floor.
I'm Malcolm Clark from New Zealand. Reading through the capacity building report, I just had a couple of sort of comments and thoughts. I think you guys have done a great job. Two aspects. The first is the proposal to look at a database relevant to deep sea mining. And I think that's going to be very, very important as DSM develops in the area. But I wonder if it comes out strongly enough that creating a database is one thing, maintaining it long term is quite another thing. And there's obviously some consideration given to trying to get startup funding to get the thing established. But I think it is potentially very important from a practical perspective to have it tied in with a longer term body which can at the very least keep it safe, secure on servers which are going to have a long term future. So tied in with university or SPC or something that's not actually mentioned in the document, the ISA database, which is already sort of up and running to some extent, that might be something else to consider. So I think it's a great idea, it's an important idea, but it's not a trivial task from my experience even within New Zealand, keeping data secure after a project has finished or if it lapses. So just one comment that could perhaps just be expanded a little bit in the document. The second one relates to sort of increasing capacity to evaluate EIAs, and one of the suggestions that's there is to sort of increase the requirement for EIAs to be done for almost any activity. That sounds a good way of increasing experience, but the EIA process is not one, again, to be taken lightly. It involves a lot of bureaucracy, a lot of administration, and so I think PICs with their limited resources need to be careful about how much you burden an administrative system which has to come in to support EIAs. So again, I'm not criticising the idea at all. I think it's a good one, but the reality of sort of getting all the checks and balances and the systems in place need to be considered quite carefully before you start sort of saying, well, we're going to do an EIA or required to have an EIA done for everything. So, thank you.
Thanks, Malcolm. I'll respond to the database access and management. I think the most logical way to move forward on that one is to build on and strengthen the database access and management in the region. By saying that, I mean we have databases that are already in existence in regional organizations, for example, at the SOPEC division of SPC, the fisheries database at FFA, and environmental database at SPREP. So it's just a matter of building on those databases and also strengthen the capacity for a long term to make sure that we maintain those databases. And I think the challenge here is the compatibility of those databases. So one of the suggestions that we come up with is the open access database, so it can be more accessible to to the region, to the countries in the region, and anyone who wants to come and work in the region. Maybe Charles or Elaine or Yannick would like to add something to what I've just mentioned. Okay, no further comment. Sam, please.
New comment, is that okay? Okay, mine's also related to the capacity building group. And again, I think it's a great start. I think one of my comments is about, or something that I think might be missing, and maybe I've missed it because I've not had a chance to absorb it completely, but looking at the long-term sustainability of the capacity building initiatives, I don't see, I guess, being mentioned. I worry that if it's always relying on funding from projects, you know, what happens when that project shuts down? And I think we've seen that example many, many times in the mining industry in the past, or land-based mining, where there has been a lot of reliance on funding from a project, and then initiatives fall apart when the project closes. I also think it needs to be a little bit more, whilst I'm not opposed to providing funding for capacity building on any level or on any means, or by any means, I think it's important to remember that companies pay quite a lot of money to countries through taxes, royalties, license fees, annual fees, et cetera, and perhaps what needs to be looked at or also considered is how these are appropriately managed to ensure that funding is available for capacity building and for assessments of projects going forward. And I think, too, we've got to look past the first project. So, yep, the first project might mean that let's say the ISA might be funding poor, but after the first project's in play, they should be receiving some kind of income which would help them assess the second project. I would have thought maybe I've got that wrong, but again, it comes down to allocating funds or ensuring that there's an allocation of funds for assessing future projects.
Yeah, thank you very much, Sam. I think you know, you just mentioned a very good practical point that's been practiced in the online mining industry. That's something that can be transferred to the offshore mining industry as well. And I think the capacity building working group, we need to probably to after the closure of the workshop, we need to look at the language that we use, especially for the data access and management component of the outcomes, and try and muscle the language to ensure that we capture how we are going to build on and strengthen the existing databases rather than creating new ones. Thank you. Yeah, Yannick, please.
All right. I think at least, thanks very much, Sam, for the comments, because I think what we're trying to do is illustrate the issues and try to produce at least some thought process towards possible solutions, but of course none of us had exact solutions at this point. And it'll be quite different, of course, for the ISA, and then in comparison to what national jurisdictions may end up setting up. But I think a lot of this will probably be a hybrid, in a way, between the contractors and the government commitments as well. There'll have to be some kind of, like you said, a legacy, a longer-term prospect. And that'll also depend a little bit, like Jim mentioned a bit yesterday, the idea of scale. Are we going to get lots and lots and lots of submissions in the next little while, or are we going to get a few here and there? Depends on the resource type. So I think even that has to eventually be examined and taken under consideration, probably both for the ISA and for the region as a whole. So I think it's more outlining where the discussion paths need to go, which is, of course, on the funding mechanisms. And I hope that at some point we'll all have some creative solutions to this.
Any other thoughts or comments about the three?